Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Happy October! This is the start of my Jessica Christine Halloween series and I am super excited. This is my favorite time of year by far. The fall, autumn, especially in New England. It's just all the leaves are turning right now. I'm looking out my window and it's so pretty. So I'm super excited to start this series. The first video of my fall series is actually about a new drink that I've become absolutely obsessed with. It's become a new trend in the food world for its incredible health benefits and delicious flavor. But this drink has actually been enhancing lives in Japan for over 1,000 years. And this is a drink that I have recently discovered. I wanted this video to be kind of a one-stop shop for everyone getting to know about matcha. So this is the one-stop shop video on YouTube for you to get to know matcha and all of the benefits and every single thing about it. You won't even have to look at anything else. Although I do recommend that you do Google it yourself and kind of like learn more about it and learn more about the history because it's very, very interesting. So this video is going to tell you all about matcha. It's going to tell you about the benefits of matcha. I'm going to tell you what I put in my matcha to make it like taste better and to, you know, spruce it up and do something a little different than normal. I'm going to tell you what time of the day I usually make it and what works best for me personally. I'm going to tell you how to properly select and prepare your matcha. I'm going to tell you why I choose organic matcha and why it's so important to make sure that you are buying an organic matcha product. I'm going to tell you the differences of the two different grades of matcha. Typically, there are two. I'm going to tell you which tools you need to make matcha. I'm going to tell you how to store your matcha and the best ways to keep it lasting long for the longest amount of time. And I will tell you, you know, the prep time, how long it usually takes me. And then I'm gonna show you how I make, you know, my hot matcha lattes or my iced matcha lattes or just my matcha tea, which I actually made this morning. Guys, matcha is so much more than just a drink. It has become a lifestyle and it is literally a way of living. It really is. When you see how it completely transforms you and completely therefore transforms your entire life, it is incredible. Like my entire life, I was like, oh my God, I can't live without Dunks. You know, America runs on Dunkin' is like their slogan. And I literally feel this way, but about matcha now. And yeah, if I could say it in a nutshell, that's how it makes me feel. So let's just jump right into this video. Okay, so the most important question, what is matcha? Matcha is a fine powder of ground whole green tea leaves. Unique from other teas, it is the only tea where the entire leaf is consumed. Only the strongest growing green tea leaves are chosen to make matcha in their production process. What makes all the difference in the production process is the fact that 3 weeks before harvest, they shade all of their green tea leaves and then the stems are removed and then they grind it into a fine powder. That's the whole process. Matcha is traditionally prepared by whisking the fine powder with hot water. And you're gonna see this whole process in my video. It is smooth and vegetal and it has like a nutty bitterness and it has a grassy and sweet taste. And if you guys didn't know, which is why I'm such a huge fan of tea, before tea was known as like a drink, it was actually known as a medicine in the world, especially in Japan. And this is why this has been so huge in Japan for the past 1,000 years, probably way more than that. But yeah, of all teas on earth, matcha is the ultimate medicine. Ultimate. Okay, so what are the benefits of matcha? It is an antioxidant powerhouse. Matcha is the highest source of antioxidants per gram, with the next highest source being goji berries, which is something that I am dying to try. They make goji berry powder, they have like actual goji berries, and I'm dying to try it, but they are super expensive. So this is like the number one source, and then it's goji berries. So this is literally even stronger, and it's, I don't have any words. I love it. So getting into like technical terms, matcha is bursting with EGCG, which is the most potent and beneficial antioxidant. EGCG is known to prevent cancer, to prevent heart disease, and is effective in reducing inflammation and slowing cartilage breakdown. So that was number one. Number two is it is alkalizing and detoxifying. With its incredibly high levels of chlorophyll, it provides oxygen to the tissues and creates a healthy alkaline pH in the body. Number three is matcha stimulates the metabolism and burns fat, which is probably one of my favorite benefits of matcha. Because right now I am trying to lose fat, and I have actually lost so much weight, and a lot of that was fat, so I'm super, super excited. I don't know if you can tell, like, in my videos, I know a lot of people have said that, like, my face has gotten, like, a lot thinner, my neck, everything like that. My body in general has as well, so I swear a huge reason for that is because I've been drinking matcha every single day. And it really does help you burn fat. And the reason why, the EGCG in matcha is found to raise the body's own rate of burning calories from 8 to 10% of daily expenditure to between 35 and 43% of daily expenditure. That is enormous. At the same time, it oxidates fat and limits intestinal absorption of fat, all while not raising your blood pressure or your heart rate. Number four, it protects your skin. I recently did a skincare routine on my channel, and recently I've been having the clearest skin ever. I can't even say enough. I'm not even wearing foundation today, guys. I'm wearing a tinted moisturizer and bronzer and blush. I'm not wearing foundation. And as you can see, my skin is very, very clear. So the main reason for this is diet, obviously, and then I go into my skincare products. I'll list my video in the description down below. But a huge reason for my clear skin is because I've been drinking matcha daily. It literally protects your skin and makes you radiate from the inside out. EGCG is proven to fight skin aging. It reduces inflammation caused by UV radiation and suppresses acne. This is a huge reason why I don't have any acne on my face. And usually, like, I'll get one or two, like, a month. It's never, like, crazy anyways, but I literally don't have any pimples on my face, and it's the best thing ever. Fifth benefit of matcha is it increases focus and it calms the mind. This is also one of my favorite benefits of matcha. The shade growing of matcha elevates the L-theanine content, which is an amino acid that induces alpha frequency brainwaves, resulting in mental calmness, improves concentration and memory, and relaxed alertness. It's just absolutely incredible. And it's all having to do with what is in the matcha. And that is where all of the health, all of the medical and all of the mental benefits come from, and why it is actually a medicine rather than just a fad, a trend drink. It's so much more than that. The sixth benefit of matcha is it is extremely energy boosting. This is my number one favorite, my absolute favorite benefit of matcha. I've never had so much energy in my entire life before I started drinking matcha. Now, a lot of people gain their energy from coffee or tea, which I'm a huge tea drinker. I always have been. Obviously, matcha is just ground up green tea leaves, so it is a tea, but it is the strongest by far. And the energy that it gives you is basically what I would describe is you don't get shaky from it ever. That is one of the benefits of the energy that it gives you. You don't get that, like, coffee shakiness that I would always get, which is the reason why I don't drink coffee. You don't have as much caffeine as you get from coffee, but you have the L-theanine. Leave in the comments if you know how to pronounce that word. Should have looked this up beforehand. But those are the two things that are in it. The theanine, I think it's called theanine, and caffeine. But it has, like, half the amount of caffeine that, like, coffee has. But you feel more energized because of the theanine. and it is the best energy booster ever. It's a calm energy booster, so you don't feel like wicked, like just like all over the place and like you can't control yourself. You don't go through withdrawals when you don't have it, really, because it's not like a high caffeine content. But yeah, it's, I feel like I can conquer the world when I have matcha. And your energy lasts up to 5.5 hours. 5.5 hours. 5.5 hours. And I can honestly say that it really does last that long. Just one serving of matcha, and I feel energized the entire day. And the thing about me is that I don't have matcha first thing in the morning. You're gonna see, I'm gonna get into this in a minute, about the time of day that I have matcha, but I don't have it right in the morning. So with the energy boosting, you don't get any jitters, you don't get any crash, and you don't get any nervous energy. It is the best form of energy you will ever have, I promise. Okay, so that does it for all of the benefits. Those are the main benefits of matcha. I hope you guys got some value out of those. The next thing I want to talk about is what I put in my matcha. So typically lately, I've just been having like a ceremonial style matcha drink, meaning I don't put anything in it. But in general, lately what I've been doing is making iced matcha lattes, which are my favorite style of having matcha. I'm sure when it starts getting a lot colder, I'll be having like hot matcha lattes with like warm frothed milk and stuff. But for now, I am making the iced matcha lattes. And with this, only a few milks work when it comes to like trying to froth it, and it has to be the brand Milk, M-A-L-K, Milk. It has to be one of those four types of milk that they have. I usually get the one in the blue bottle, just the unsweetened, and I'll also get like the vanilla one in the tannish cream bottle, which is also unsweetened. So those are the only milks that really work with like frothing, or like an oat milk. That's what I have come up with. Leave in the comments down below what your favorite type of milk to use when you're making a matcha ice latte is. I'd love to know. So what I put in my matcha latte. A lot of people like to put honey. I personally don't eat honey because I am vegan, but you can always replace honey with agave nectar, which I like to do when I'm craving something like a little bit sweeter and I don't want to like go completely off the rail with my diet and have like something really bad for myself. I'll put like a sweetener in my matcha latte and it'll just like hit the spot and be perfect. So I will go in with agave nectar. I will also go in with maple syrup, which I think is my favorite sweetener to put in the matcha lattes. There's just something about it. It's just so good. You can also put vanilla extract. When I was at Whole Foods, they recommended me to put like a shot of vanilla in it if like I wanted it to be sweetened. Like I said, I usually do ceremonial style, so I'll just do milk and then the matcha, and that's it. I don't usually sweeten it. 95% of the time I don't sweeten it. But if I do, I will use maple syrup, vanilla extract, agave nectar, date syrup, or monk fruit sugar. And those are like the only things that I usually go in with. If you guys have like your own spin on a matcha latte, leave down below things that you like to put in yours as well. What time of day do I make it? So usually I make it anywhere between 12:30 p.m. and 2:30 p.m. This is typically, I don't want to say my crash time, but a time when, you know, I've been doing things all morning, and, you know, especially between 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. when I try to be my most productive. Actually, in humans, if you didn't know, that is the most productive time of day. It's 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. So that is when I try to be the most productive and get the hardest things on my to-do list done. So by the end of that, I'm usually pretty like tired or like losing some energy, so that's when I want a pick-me-up, and matcha is what I use as a pick-me-up because it is such a great energy booster, and I find that it works best for me in the afternoon. In the morning, I like to go in with like a hot green tea, just like a regular green tea, make sure it's organic, everything, but that's typically what I like to do, either iced or hot green tea in the morning. And then I'll switch over to matcha anywhere between 12:30 and 2:30 p.m. Next is how to select and prepare your matcha. So I am not going to go into particular brands in this video because I want to let you guys make that decision on which brands you want to pick. I don't really have, like, I haven't tried enough different brands to know which ones are, like, really good, and I just know the ones that I have right now I absolutely love, but I don't really want to say the name of them because I want to leave that up to you guys and experiment. And, you know, I'm not sponsoring any brand here, I'm not sponsored, so I just want you guys to figure out which one works for you. As long as you follow, like, my guide of, like, how to pick out the right matchas, you guys will be all set. It won't really matter which brand. What I will tell you is that I like to choose matcha that is organically grown in Yuji, Kyoto, Japan. And I'll leave, like, the spelling here because I'm sure we're gonna be like, what? Here are the main qualities to look for in your matcha. You want a vibrant hue. So the matcha that I have is like a bright, vibrant green color. You don't want anything that is like a dull green. It's just probably not gonna be the best quality. However, matcha does oxidize when it hits air, similar to avocados. So you don't want it to start turning brown either, and that is why purchasing matcha direct from the farm that packages it is so important. The next thing I want to talk about is Japanese matcha versus Chinese matcha. Matcha is typically not shade grown in China, which makes it a huge difference. Like I said, the most important part of the development process is the fact that they shade the leaves in Japan, and this will lead to more of like a dull and bitter matcha product. That is the main thing to look out for. Make sure that it's from Japan, honestly. Japan matcha is shade grown and it will lead to the most vibrant and best tasting matcha. Next is, why do I choose organic matcha? The reason is very simple. Tea leaves have no protection. Any synthetic fertilizers, any chemicals that are being sprayed on these leaves, you will ingest. And for me, I just don't want to do that. So to make sure, it's so important to get organic, especially when you're buying online. You want to make sure that it has that USD organic on there. Even non-GMO is really good. Less than 1% of teas sold in the US are actually organic, which is really crazy. So the more we support organic farmers, the more we are telling them that that is what we want, and the more that we are making it known in the world that there is a higher demand for organic. Next is, which grade of matcha should you choose? Typically, there are some brands that make 3 grades. However, there's 2 main grades of matcha. That is ceremonial grade and culinary grade. This is so important. The main difference from one grade to the next is harvest time. Ceremonial is a premium matcha product. Premium. You cannot get better than ceremonial grade. It's from the first harvest in May. Very smooth, grassy, and delicate. It is best for traditional matcha preparation. However, it is typically 4 times more expensive than culinary grade matcha, but there is a reason for that. In my opinion, it is completely worth it. This is the grade that I will get. I refuse to get any other grade. I just believe that it is the higher and superior premium quality. Culinary grade is the second harvest in June. It is moderately grassy and bitter. It's best for baking and smoothies. I have yet to bake or make a smoothie with matcha. I've only made like the lattes or tea. So I can't really say anything about like the baking aspect of it, but either way, I would use ceremonial grade personally. So next is, what tools do you need to make matcha? So there are many ways to do it, but I like to do it the traditional way, how they've done it in Japan for years. So you're gonna need a traditional bamboo whisk and holder. So the bamboo whisk makes it so that you can properly whisk the powder, and it gives you the smoothest matcha. And the holder just keeps the whisk in shape. It keeps it from like falling apart, and it just looks nice on your counter. And this is my bamboo whisk holder. It's cute, right? It's cute, like, just to sit on your countertop. Next, you need a fine sieve and bamboo scoop. So it's like a teaspoon, basically. I use a traditional bamboo scoop to portion my matcha. Usually you do like 1 teaspoon. I know some people do 2 teaspoons, but this bamboo scoop is going to give you an accurate amount of matcha every time. You're gonna have to sift it through with a fine sieve, though I like to call the fine sieve a fine strainer because I didn't even know what a sieve was, and I definitely didn't know how to pronounce it at all. I thought it was a sieve. I was saying sieve for the longest time, and my mom was just like, that's not how you say it. So basically the fine sieve is going to make sure that you don't have any clumps of matcha in your drink. You also need a wide matcha bowl. This is the wide matcha bowl I'm talking about. I bought this on Amazon. I bought all of these things on Amazon. They have a bunch of different options. You can choose which ones you like, but this is cute to me. So this is where you make your matcha. You would put the fine sieve over here like this. You would be sifting the matcha like this into the bowl into a very fine powder. Then I have like the little bowl holder like they do in Japan. It's so cute. These are just things that you really do need to make matcha, especially if you want to make it the traditional way like I did. The last thing you'll need is optional, but I personally absolutely love it, and it is a handheld or any type of milk frother. If you have a regular milk frother, that's cool, but I think the handheld milk frothers are amazing. I got mine on Amazon, and it's this one. I got the stainless steel one because I think it's just cute and it'll go with everything in your kitchen. And this is the end of it, and when I turn it on, oh my god, this had like water in it because I cleaned it. It just went all over my face. Wow. That's what it looks like. It goes super fast, guys. You want to make sure that this is actually like in your drink before you put it in, obviously. Because I made that mistake once, believe it or not. So this is the handheld frother. This will make the pictures of like an at-home latte look phenomenal. It'll look like you just got it from a cafe, so I highly recommend one of these too. So the last part is how to store your matcha. And how I store my matcha, and the best way to do it, is in the refrigerator. You want to keep it away from sunlight and away from extreme warmth. So you want to buy it in the package that it comes in from the farm. Usually it's usually an airtight sealed package or container, and you want to keep it in that container if possible. You can move it to like another airtight container, but just it has to be airtight because, like I said, it oxidizes when it hits air and turns brown. How long will it last? It will last unopened about a year. If you opened it, it will last, you want to use it up between 1 to 2 months, usually. 3 months is a stretch, but you can. If it is expired, you just want to put it in smoothies or bake with it, because it's not going to taste as good in like a latte or tea. This is why, typically, because at first, when I first started using matcha, I was like, on Amazon and every store, I was like, why do they only serve it in like 1 ounce containers? Like, that's such a little amount. And it's because no one will go through like more than that in like, you know, a month or two. So it's the perfect amount, honestly. It is expensive, considering it being 1 ounce, but like I said, health is wealth, and I like to invest in my health, and matcha is a great way to do that. It takes about 5 minutes to make matcha. It really doesn't take that long to make, and it just makes you feel so good all day. So like 5 minutes out of the day and then feeling amazing and accomplishing all of your goals. And yeah, I hope you guys really got value out of this part of the video. And now I'm going to show you how to make a matcha latte, a hot matcha latte, an iced matcha latte, and matcha tea. So I hope you guys got value out of this video. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. And leave in the comments down below what your favorite part about matcha is, how you like to make your matchas, and then hashtag JC Matcha Challenge, tag me on Instagram in your pictures, let me see what you you've made and what types of brands you've gotten for matcha. Leave down below your favorite brand so that we can talk in the comments about brands that we all love and can recommend some great organic matcha brands. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed my first video of my Jessica Christine Halloween series. And yeah, the whole month of October, my plan is to do all fall themed videos. Doesn't typically have to be like Halloween, but fall themed videos. And I'm so excited to start. It's my favorite time of year. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Please leave in the comments recommendations of fall videos that you would like to see. Follow me on Instagram at JessChristineX3. And yeah, have a great day, guys. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.